Let us see how heat gets transferred from a hot object to cold object. So heat is transferred in three ways, that is conduction, convection and radiation. All this you have experienced in our day-to-day life, only we don't use the word conduction, convection and radiation. Okay, so conduction, right? You know, like sometimes your mother would have kept something in the stove, right? And should have asked you to go and stir it. Should have left that spoon or that laddu in the vessel itself, right? And you say, should tell, okay, go and stir that whatever she is cooking, okay? Maybe some curry or something like that. You, without knowing, you just go and touch that spoon. What will happen? You just withdraw the hand, right? Why? Because the spoon has become hot. How it has become hot, right? It is actually by conduction. So we learn about conduction. Convection. You know that microwave oven. Microwave oven is by convection method. It's the convection method of heating. That also we learn about it, right? Radiation. Every day we are receiving the heat from the sun. How we are getting that heat from the sun? That is by radiation method. Okay? So let us see what each type of transfer of heat. So let us start with conduction. Conduction is a transfer of heat due to vibration of particles. Vibration of particles. What is particle? You take any object, they are all made up of tiny particles, we know. They are called molecules, right? You know very well. Any object, any matter is made up of tiny particles, that is called molecule. You can conduct this experiment, right? That is, you take a needle, right? And to that needle, wax beads. How to make wax beads? You take the candle, light it. When it will start melting, you drop it and you get that beads, right? That you insert in this needle. Then you light one end of the needle with the help of candle. After some time, you can see that the first bead will melt and it will drip. Okay, it will drop, right? Next, you see the next one will melt, right? So that indicates that the needle is made up of tiny particle. So at first that particle will absorb the heat and it will vibrate. So it is all made up of particle. As it vibrates, it will transfer the heat. That is actually conduction. Conduction is usually seen in metals. It is seen in metals, okay? So that's why usually the cooking vessels, the utensils are made up of metals because they cook faster and then it is again by conduction, okay? What is conductors and what are insulator? Conductors are the substances which will allow the heat to pass through it. Whichever substance which allow the heat to pass through it, they are called conductors, okay? They are the utensils, okay? Usually utensils are made up of metals because metals are a very good conductor of heat. Then, you know, that frying pan or that tawa, everything, it has a handle. Cookers and all will have handle. The handle is made up of bakelite, a type of plastic called bakelite. Why they are attached with bakelite? Because it is an insulator. It will not allow the heat to pass through it. That's why it's called insulator. The plastic, right? And the bakelite, they are made up of, they are insulators because they won't allow the heat to pass through them. So thereby we get protected by the heat. That's why the utensils will be having handles which are made up of insulator. So that's about conduction. Next, let us go to what is convection. Convection is a transfer of heat due to actual movement of particle. Due to actual movement of particle. That means, I just may try to make you understand here. Just take one vessel today. Okay, take the vessel and take some water, put it on a stove. Keep it on a stove. Okay, keep it on a stove under your parents' guidance. Okay, alright. Okay, so now take the water the water when it starts heating, you can see the bubbles coming here. From the bottom, the bubbles comes up, right? Then, and if you continue to heat, you can see more bubbles forming and the bubbles coming to top, and there is movement of this water, right? Okay, so what is happening here means that when the heat water is absorbing heat, so the water which is at the bottom, it absorbs the heat, and as well as it absorbs heat, it becomes lighter. It becomes lighter in phase, and it will come to the top, right? As it comes to the top, there is vacancy created, and the water which is not heated up, which is colder here on top, will come to its place and it will take its place. So this is the actual movement of particles, that is convection. Convection is seen in liquids as well as gases. Liquids and gases. So liquid I told you. Gases, right? See, in your like we used to have exhaust fan. We used to have exhaust fan. Why we used to have exhaust fan? Usually we have exhaust fan in kitchen, right? So we have exhaust fan. So if this is the kitchen, so in somewhere in the corner, we keep the exhaust fan. Why it is kept in the kitchen? You know very well. When you start cooking, right? So when you start cooking, so that the heat which is colder, right? That is the heat when the air in the kitchen will get heated up. As the air gets heated up, it will come to the top. It will come to the top and it will be sent out through the exhaust fan, and the cold air will occupy this region. Okay, the hot air will be thrown out and the cold air will take its place. So this is convection. Okay, so on that basis only we have something called sea breeze and land breeze. So what is the sea breeze and land breeze? So imagine this is land. So this is land. So I'll show you a house here. So this is land. And here we have the sea. Okay. So during the day, what will happen? The land will get heated up very fast. You know very well. Whereas the water will not absorb the heat very fast, nor it will lose the heat very fast. So here, what happens? The air, as the land gets heated up, and the air gets heated up, what will happen? It will become lighter, and it becomes lighter, it will come towards the sea. Okay, and see here, the heat is less, so the colder air will come and occupy here. That is called sea breeze. Okay, as the air gets heated up, it will become lighter and it will come to the top. And here what happens? The heat is less. Okay, the air here is colder. So what will happen? As space is created, this air or the breeze will come and occupy this region. Thereby, it helps us to maintain the cooler air. Okay, so that's how the air circulates. So that is called sea breeze. That is during the daytime. In the night, what happens? So as I told you, the night the land will lose the heat quickly. In the night, always during the day, it will absorb the heat quickly. During the night, it will lose the heat quickly. But in case of the sea, during the day, it will not absorb the, as I told you, water will not absorb heat quickly, nor it will lose the heat quickly. So what will happen? So here, during the night, what will happen? As the air here in the land is colder, and here the water, near the sea, the air is warmer. So what will happen? The warmer air will move here. job to the land and the colder air will come to the sea. Okay, so this is called land breeze. So that's the difference between sea breeze and land breeze. Next is radiation. So radiation is, I told you, radiation does not require any medium. I told, like, convection is through liquid, heat transfer takes place in liquid or in the gases, or in case of conduction, that is metals. And radiation does not need any medium, doesn't need a metal, doesn't need a liquid, doesn't need a gas for transference of heat. Transfer of heat from hot to hot object to cold object without any medium, even through vacuum also it can transfer the heat. That is called radiation. That's how we get the sun's heat. Sun's heat reaches us through the vacuum. You know, space is vacuum, we know very well, right? So that's how the heat will reach us. That is radiation. As I told you, all the three we experience. So let us take one utensil, let us put water and let us keep it on a heater. Okay, imagine you are keeping it on a heater. So we used to have a heater. Okay, now all the three you can see here. When the vessel gets heated up, that is what? That is conduction. The vessel getting heated up is conduction. And whatever we have kept it inside, that may the liquid, okay, the curry, that gets heated up due to what? Convection. Convection. Okay, right? Then, as I told you, this heater, you are not touching, you are just standing in front of it. You can feel the heat, right? You can feel that heat, that is because of radiation. Not only that, see, we cook, whatever we cook it, then we keep it aside. After some time, it would have become cold. How it becomes cold? It is because of radiation. That is, it will lose the heat to the surrounding, that is radiation. So this is how heat gets transferred by conduction, convection and radiation. Okay, I hope you understood. Okay, yes, with that we have finished with the lesson. Thank you.